Well, this morning we have the privilege to celebrate a wonderful, really two wonderful occasions. We're here to wish Eileen a happy 80th birthday. That is hard to believe. And we also want to celebrate her tenure as organist. Most of you probably have no idea, but Eileen has been playing the organ at Salem solo, on her own, being the organist for 44 years. That is a tremendous tenure of service, and we appreciate her being so faithful, not just on Sunday mornings, but for funerals and for revival or for special services. She's always willing to jump in and play and make sure that we have music to make our services much, much better. So Eileen, thank you so much. We are glad we get to celebrate with you this morning. And here's just a little video of some of the high points of how you have served faithfully in our church, in our community, and with your family.
To play the piano. My mom and dad brought one of these big upright pianos, and I guess I was about 10 years old, and I had a lady come and teach me. Each week she'd come to the house, and I took piano lessons from her, and she said, would you like to learn the organ to play, because the church was right by us. And I said, yeah, I guess I'll take it for a while. So I took organ lessons for about a year, and then I was able to play in the church locally for a little bit there, but not a lot, but I played there a little bit.
How old were you then?
I was about 15, 16 years old, and then I kind of quit. Other things came available.
Fantastic piano player. And Mrs. Hutton would have Carol and I go first because she knew that we didn't practice and it would be a short lesson and that she could relax and listen to your beautiful music because you just always practice and your lessons were perfect. And so, you know, Carol and I both quit because we would never measure up to what you did.
Well, I didn't pick it back up till after I was married, and my husband was involved in the church in Marcus Hook, where we lived in Pennsylvania, and he was in charge of the Sunday school, and they needed somebody to play piano in Sunday school, so I picked it up there and played in the Sunday school, and kept it going from there on until we moved to Virginia. So I stepped up at Salem and played the organ. I think I've been doing it for like 40 years now, every Sunday. But I would rather play the organ than the piano, really. Yes. I think it's easier for me, you know, because I guess I've mastered a little bit of, you know, trying to put all three of them together, and it's easier, and I love to do it.
When I think about Eileen, I think some of the words that come to mind for me are humble, faithful, incredibly generous. Our first visit to Sparta a long time ago included an afternoon at Pitts Pond, and I can just remember the gracious hostess that she is, making sure everybody feels at home and is having a great time, and they have shared that place, their backyard, with our whole community and the region, really, for just decades, and what a blessing that has been. She and Don have loved our church family and our community, and have invested in it and been such a big part of it for so long, in missions and ministry, not just church services. They both shared a heart for missions, and Eileen has continued to serve on our missions team and supports and encourages our folks that go around the world to share the gospel. I think also when I think about Eileen, I think there's a calm presence about her because of her faith in the Lord. Walking through some family struggles or tragedies with her and her family, Eileen always had this calm assurance that the Lord was still the Lord. One Christmas Eve, I think it was, Don fell out of a tree stand and fractured a vertebrae in his back, and we didn't know how he was going to be. And typically you'd find a spouse anxious and when I got to Eileen, she was concerned for Don, but she knew that the Lord had this. I don't even know how many years ago we changed our tradition. When I first came to Salem, our baptisms were in the basement of the old fellowship hall in a baptismal that's in the floor and the stage. And 15, maybe 20 years ago, we said, why don't we do baptism at the pond? We approached Don and Eileen. Other churches were already doing that. They said, sure, that would be great. And now it has become a tradition where we gather at a special place in the lives of most of the folks in our church family anyway, a place where families celebrate, where Little League teams celebrate, and now the church celebrates, not just to have a dinner and a picnic and enjoy the pond, but we celebrate just like they celebrate in heaven whenever anyone's baptized. So we share in baptism, and then we enjoy the fellowship of families and church family together as we enjoy such a beautiful, beautiful place.
So I can remember when Mom was, we were all younger, and she would every Saturday have to go down to church in the afternoons and just practice for the Sunday's worship service. So it was fun to me when I was younger because I would go with her and play all around the church sanctuary, jumping up on the pulpit, pretending like I was the preacher, turn the microphone on and shout and start singing like I really could sing, and rolling across the pews and whatnot until she finally had enough of it and didn't take me anymore. But she had a bird's eye view of me and my brother and sister when we were teenagers in church, when she was always sitting at the piano or the organ, and she could always spot us if we were talking too much or doing something that we shouldn't be doing instead of listening to the preacher. Memories of my mother being a strong and faithful woman as she is, and the strong organ player that she is. She decided to play the organ at my grandmother's funeral, which is her mother. And I do recall when she started playing up, and she was just tapping away on the keyboard, just going to the music, and just a strong and stoic. And seeing her like that in a sad situation where most of us would be selfishly grieving, she just poured her whole heart and soul into.
Yeah, I felt like I should do this for Mom because she's the one that helped me, push me to learn how to play the piano. And we didn't have nobody at the time of her service to do that, so I stepped up and said, I'll play. I want to play for Mom. So I played the organ for her service. Yes, I did.
And in the past few years, knowing how she deals with grief has helped me along with the tragic loss of my son and some other things that went on through all that, and just giving me the strength.
I have watched her play the organ at church. The funeral home will call her in a hour's notice, and she'll go right over and help them out. She personifies what it is to be a giving, godly woman. I've never heard her say a bad thing about anybody. She's faithful to God. She always says, that God will work things out, even some of the darkest days that our family has experienced. Ma was the example of go sit at the feet of Jesus. Just sit there and provide comfort.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ma. Happy birthday to you.
I pray for the next decade. Should the Lord give you those 10 years, that you would continue just to serve and do what the Lord has gifted you to do in serving Him and His church.